Following the spring showcase, Chad Welker with the Zips Digital Network, covering for Joe Dunn today on another assignment. But Coach, just briefly this week, how did practice go for you leading into this week?
You know what? We had a really good week of practice. Tuesday was not up to our standard. Really challenged the team following that practice. They came out and they had a great day on Thursday, and we had a very good day today.
There was a lot of events going on over the course of the week. You had football alumni here yesterday for a flag football game. You obviously had the spring showcase. The involvement of everybody to be a part of this program, how important is that for you right now?
Well, it's critical, and that's really what today was all about for us. It's all about our football family. You notice, I mean, we've had recruits out here at every practice. This is the only practice that we don't have recruits here, and that's because it's all about us. We have all of our incoming freshmen, all of our signees, their families, our current players and their families that came in last night. We had a great dinner together. We're having a barbecue after this practice and just really, celebrating the Akron football family and allowing these people to get a chance to know one another.
Breaking down each position group, starting with the offense for how they did over the course of the week.
I think it was a good week. Like I said, Tuesday was not a great day at all on either side of the ball. Thursday, offense came back, had a really, really great practice. And I think today it was pretty evenly split. Offense won the situation portion of the practice. Defense did a great job coming back in team and really not allowing the offense to do much with the football. So it was good on both sides. Special teams, I thought were good. I thought they were competitive. I thought the guys understood the drills and went out and executed at a pretty high level.
And then from the defensive and special team side, what'd you see that you liked out of them?
Well, really just the resiliency and their ability to bounce back, because the way that we had kind of set up this practice regarding all of our situations, there were points that were awarded offensively and defensively. And after the offense won that first two-minute drive, that really, that put the defense out of it. Yet they came back in the team period. They played the same. They played the same regardless of the situation, regardless of the circumstance, and really dominated the team period. So that was really positive to see.
And then from a spring showcase standpoint, you guys went with the kind of glorified practice, having many people. What was the reasoning kind of behind that instead of doing like a typical spring game?
Well, you don't get a whole lot of work done, in a spring game. We have too much to work on. We have too much to improve on, too many fundamentals, too many techniques to teach. And if we just came out and kind of did that scrimmage, I mean, just not a lot gets done. As you can see, we probably got the least out of, that 20 minutes of practice of anything that we had. So, but it's important. It's important to get those guys out there and to put them in those situations as well, to learn how to how to drive the football, to learn how to stop drives, and I think it's been very positive thus far.
And then lastly, something that was kind of unique as well is that you still have three more practices after showing kind of the showcase to the fans. What is going to be the goal and the expectations you've set for your team this last week in spring ball?
It's really the same as it's been, since we started. Come out here and to give it everything that we have, to have great attitude, great effort, and everything that we do, to be extremely competitive, extremely tough, throughout these practices. And, in these last two on Tuesday and Thursday, we need to get better. We have a lot of work to do, a lot of areas that we need to improve. And, I think our team knows that, and I expect them to come out and to finish this thing the way that they started it.
Appreciate the time as always, Coach. And fans, we're less than 140 days away from the home opener here when the Zips take on UAB. So make sure you get your season tickets today by calling 888-99-ACRON. For the Zips Digital Network, this is Chad Welker. Have a great week. And as always, go Zips!